Jamaica, Jamaica. KFC. I gotta try that KFC before I leave, man.
And now there's a construction burn on the side of KFC.
Then. Oh, yeah?
Yeah, for the Wendy's.
Oh, they're building the Wendy's?
Well, Wendy's is already here.
Ah.
On the other side.
So okay.
So now they're bringing it closer to the Burger King.
Right. I'm sure Burger King is probably good here, too. Man, they getting very Americanized down here in Jamaica, I see.
Yep.
They growing. YouTube, it's your boy Raji Raj back here with another video. That's right, I'm here in Trelawney, Jamaica. I'm staying here at the Ocean Eden beautiful resort. Just got here last night, finally got some daylight, and I decided I'm going to take you guys on a little bit of tour, show you around Ocean Eden. At the end of this vlog, I'm going to review Ocean Eden, let you guys know if it's a go or if it's a no. But again, here I am, Ocean Eden, capturing every moment, exploring every bit. Let's go.
Because there's only five places in which you guys can travel with us. And that's like, you know, North Korea, Pakistan, Afghanistan.
Oxtail dinner. Now this is what you call exploring every bit of Ocean Eden. So we just left the lobby. This is one lobby, one of two lobbies. So if you come to Ocean Eden, you actually have access to Ocean Eden and Ocean Springs, right? They're two separate resorts. Between both resorts, you are open to, you have access to 14 restaurants. So we've been here for a couple of hours since last night till now, and we already ate of probably three of the restaurants. And I would say the food so far is amazing. So we just left the lobby and we're walking straight towards the pool, okay? So this here is still all Ocean Eden property. So this is the pool right here. At the pool you have a swimmer bars, you have cabanas, right? Right now you see people just out relaxing. The resort right now is low occupancy rate. So it's not at 100 because of the season. Per the front desk person, after the 20th, it's going to be at 100%. So right now, it's probably at about a 60% occupancy right now. So there's not too many people here, which gives us access to a lot of things, right? We're not going to wait in line for stuff. But here's the pool, and the pool pretty much takes you straight to the beach. Okay. So I was just talking about how I want some Jamaican fruits. And so I was at the restaurant and I was gifted with this very big piece of jackfruit, right? So I took it home, well, back to the hotel, about to unwrap this bad boy, and I'm going to devour it. I wish I had a knife. Ah, it's very ripe, so it's hard to get in there. But I grew up eating this as a kid. Yeah, there you go. So you pretty much get the meat, you pluck the seed out, and very ripe. Looks like here, you take the seed out, it's so ripe that it's a little slippery. So FYI, a lot of vegans use this as meat substitute. All right,
the next day.
Hey man, that's bro right there, man. I haven't seen bro in years, man. Years. God damn, bro. Hey, man. That's bro right here, man.
Hi.
Hey, I'm recording. You know,
Yeah. Got it. What's going on, man? Yeah, that's my dad right here.
Hi.
And that's my brother. Yeah, it's been what, 20 years? 20 years, man. Huh? 20 years, man. Just came to Sharky's, yeah. And look at these portions. So I got the escovitch fish, comes with rice. And look at this big bowl here. Let me see a king crab there. This is a king crab or just a
king crab and lobster?
A lobster. Lobster.
Oh my god.
Wow. Man. Oh yeah. So just left this small place to eat here. I think this is Centons, and definitely a 5 out of 5. The food was amazing and the portions were big. If you come to Jamaica, you stay in Ocean Eden, make sure you come check out this place here. Beautiful place, great food, good staff. And if you're a seafood person like I am, you'll really enjoy it. And the portions are big. I think I already said that, but I'm saying it again. That's how great it was, right? So if you come to Ocean Eden, make sure you check this place out, all right? 5 out of 5. Miss Bell here is going to demonstrate to you how you eat a soursop. So
just to let you guys know, so soursop is an extremely fleshy fruit, and it has a big black seed in the middle, okay? So that's the seed, right? And fun fact, I'm actually growing a soursop tree at my house currently. So I will show you guys the progress and keep you guys tuned in as it grow into a big tree and it starts giving me nice succulent fruits like the one here Siobhan is eating. But yes, soursop, y'all. Soursop. Look how juicy that is. Very good fruit for you. Very good fruit.
The next morning.
So going on our first excursion. On the way. Boat.
Same boat.
Okay. So this road to our right take you to the school where Usain Bolt start his career. Yeah, but this road take you to the school. William Neff, you see it? Yeah, but this road. So in a famous march today. March of the Lord. World fastest man in the world.
Several tours they're doing here all at once, but we are doing the rafting tour. So the rafting tour is where they take you on a raft and you get a leg massage. They also have the full body massage, but obviously I'm not doing it and Siobhan's not doing it, but this is where they do the tour. So I'm here, the bus is dropping everybody off, and I'm ready to have some fun because I'm tired of the resort life. So stay tuned, fun to come. I'm gonna capture every moment and explore every bit. We made it to the rafting location. It's raining a bit, but we're gonna do our best to still enjoy. We're gonna do our best to enjoy this time out. But yes, we have made it.
Okay. Thank you.
So here we are in the mountains rafting. It's raining. It's raining like crazy. And we almost canceled the tour. But we decided, you know what? It's our last day in Jamaica. Well, not our last day in Jamaica, but this is our
first excursion in Jamaica.
First excursion in Jamaica. Perhaps, maybe last. For a long time, so you know what, we decided to just go ahead and go.
There's rum in there, right?
Yeah. So we're gonna take this mile on the raft of Captain Randy, you see in the front there, and this is what it's gonna be. Beautiful though. Too bad we didn't have some sunshine out here, but we're gonna make the best of it. The rain makes it a little more therapeutic.
Some reggae music.
Some reggae music. We have some rum punch in there we're about to get to in a minute. And this is the life, y'all. Jamaica, Jamaica.
She's not afraid and ashamed.
Okay.
I don't need no straw.
No, no straw. That's good. That's rum. That's rum and I.
So what after fires?
Thank you so much.
Rum punch strong.
Oh, I love a rum. Yes. Oh, man.
I even got extra, even though I made this morning, though, right?
Okay.
So, you guys needed to bring it back to the table.
All right. Cheers. What's up, we are with rain is coming down, y'all, but it ain't gonna stop our show. It's not gonna stop our show. Living the life in Jamaica. Hey, listen, you don't get any better than this. Yes. Oh, yeah. Jamaica, Jamaica. Yeah, man. Listen, y'all. We finally escaped the resort today. We decided we're going to get away. Because after a while, that resort life becomes the resort life, right? You're seeing the same thing, doing the same thing, and seeing the same people. So it's important when you come, when you leave your country and you come to the island or wherever you go in the world, always do some excursions. Get away, see the local people. Greet the local people, spend some money, see different things, see the culture of where you're going, right? That's why we travel, to see culture, right? And look at this. This does not get any better, man. This does not get any better. Out here on the raft, I'm getting chauffeured. It's raining, but guess what? It did not damper our excursion. Almost did, though. We are doing the mud rub. What is this called exactly?
Limestone,
right?
Yeah,
and limestone. This is
exfoliating.
And it's good for exfoliating. It's good for pain in the legs, you said, and knees.
Pain in joints.
And joints.
Good like for stretch marks, pain in joints, and all like mosquito bites.
Oh, okay. Jamaica, Jamaica.
Funny love, never gonna break my heart. Funny love, never gonna tear it up. Oh, yeah. Don't love me for me money, I tell me money, but don't love me love for dancing. Girlfriend, don't love me for me car.
What's your name again, brother?
Randy,
yeah. Listen, when y'all come to Jamaica and do the rafting tour, make sure y'all see Randy. All right. So we're doing the limestone.
Just like you're needing a dumpling, all right?
Corn? Oh, okay, okay.
Uh-huh.
So I'm here, I just got done doing an excursion, and on property, they have these little areas where you can do additional stuff that's attached to the cruise, to the excursion that we just did. But it's raining pretty hard out here right now, so we're just gonna chill, get something to eat. But an extension to, as an extension of the rafting that we did, you also get to do the slide. You get to do some type of, over here, forgot what this is called, but you get to walk up the rocks and take pictures, and there's little pool areas there. So it's a nice place. It's a nice package deal. But like I said, it's raining a lot. You can't see it on camera, but it's raining real hard right now. So we're just gonna chill and get something to eat, and hopefully the rain will hold up by then. And some festival dumpling, jerk chicken, festival dumpling. Jerk chicken and festival dumpling.
Come on, let's go. Let's go on an adventure. Don't be scared. Come along. Don't be scared.
It's too cold.
Hey, welcome to Jamaica, man. Come on.
Dangerous right here. It's 7 foot. If we turn back around. Absolutely beautiful. No, don't go down there. 7 feet. Beautiful, y'all. Look at this view. About to do some bowling here on property. I'm going to this bowling hall here, see what this is about. So this is a very common fruit that we see in the States, but there's nothing like Jamaican papaya. I was at market today and I happened to purchase it, took it home. I want to show you, show the viewers papaya. Most of y'all are already familiar with it, but again, there's nothing like Jamaican papaya. Everything in Jamaican tastes different than what you'd get in America. But yes, look at the beauty of this. Look at the beauty of this, all right? So again, I'm going to devour this papaya, all right? So papaya is also fleshy. You take the seeds out. I also have a papaya tree at the house I'm currently growing, right? Along with my soursop and along with my jackfruit tree. I peel it, peel the skin. See how nice and orange it is, or it might be colorblind. I'm not sure what color that is. It looks orange to me, but slice that bad boy, and yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I definitely will be eating this entire papaya by myself tonight, just so y'all know.
The next morning.
Good morning, YouTube. Roger Rod checking in again. Day 4, Trelawney, Jamaica, Ocean, Eden. It's early in the morning. We got up early this morning so that we can make it to our tour event and that we don't miss it, right? So today's tour is gonna be Bob Marley, where we get to see his where he lived. We get to visit his grave. We get to, you know, see the people, see some local people, eat some local food, hopefully do some shopping. Again, it's day 4. This is our very last excursion, so I'm excited about it. And again, people, like I tell you guys, when you guys come on vacation and come to these resorts, always make sure that you do some excursions, right? Because in my opinion, it don't count, right? Unless you're out there and you're seeing some local stuff, you're mingling with some local people, you know? So just don't be stuck at a resort, right? The resorts are beautiful, there are activities, but if you want your vacation to really count and be meaningful, you gotta come out and you gotta touch the people and you gotta see how beautiful Jamaica is. I'm gonna keep taking you guys on a tour. I'm gonna show you guys some activities and together we're gonna explore every bit of it. Yeah, man. Time to get on this Bob Marley bus.
Having lunch is not at the Bob Marley. After you finish the tour, you're gonna make your way back on this bus and then we drive you to a restaurant known as Island Fork. That's where you'll be having lunch.
Site doing some viewing. It's beautiful up here. We took a lot of pictures. Now we're at the souvenir shop. Feeling a little festive.
You know why? You know the reason why all the way up? If you are not going up, you are going, leave that one to Mary J. Blige. I'm going down, cause you're not around.
Yeah. And he drops it.
Okay then, she can go down. You know why? We not around. Anyway. Next thing, don't worry about getting close. I'm a vegetarian. Next thing, don't worry about COVID. You know why? We smoke it already. I'm not done yet. We not only smoke it, they call it coronavirus, right? You ever heard about Corona beer? We drink. Just put that in the lime. Oh my God. All right, family, I'm here, cuz. I'm here for you, cuz. I'm here for you. And yeah, right, sir. And anyway, now, good evening, everyone. And don't be surprised, I know it's morning. And I'm saying good evening. But here at Reggaeland, Bob Marley birthplace, there is no morning, there is no midday. There's only evening. You know why? every day here, all day, it's 420. Anyway, yes, get it, man. Get the video going. We have a lot more.
Yeah,
we have a lot more. We have a lot more. Now, you don't hear me? All right, you know, this. I didn't give you my name, right? Which I should introduce my name first, but I don't. I introduce jokes first. Because when I introduce joke first now, when you hear my name now, then you understand why. Ask me my name.
What's your name?
Captain Crazy. So the tour start here now. This house right here. It was the house of Bob Marley's grandparents. The name was Omaria Malcolm Alberta Malcolm. Bob Mom, Sidella Malcolm, then Marley. She gave birth to Bob in this house.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. On the 6th of February, 1945. Anybody remember the time?
6:20.
I love you.
Touch again. You deserve another touch.
Mm-hmm. You know
what
time our shuttle picked us up for the
clip? Yeah, 4:20. No. One more thing though. Many people don't know. Did you notice that was white?
Yes.
Yeah, from England. Liverpool. Yeah. So they call Bob Marley Cappuccino. Black and white. Let me look around. Did that kind of look like him?
This is all of Bob Marley's achievements. We're still on his property, and these are all of his achievements. All his own. All of Bob Marley's achievements. Gold album. Oh,
So just a quick tour of the property. So this is Ocean Eden's lobby right here, which gives you access to all of this. Including the pool that leads to the beach. So if you stay here at Ocean Eden, you'll be staying either on the right or you'll be on the left. Now the cool thing about it, and obviously you have access to a few restaurants, you have access to the Census dinner show, which gives you some great nightly shows. I definitely look forward to those every night. And you have access to a few restaurants. You have a steakhouse right here, which I haven't tried yet, so I can't review it. You got a bar right here, and bars are pretty much everywhere on this property. Literally, like, bars are everywhere, and it's included. So you could drink as much as you want, as much as your system will tolerate. And you have a buffet right here, which I frequent on a regular. Now if you go through here, it says Ocean Springs. It takes you on the other side, which you also have access to if you stay here at Ocean Eden. Or if you stay at Ocean Springs, you also have access to Ocean Eden. You have a disco right here. Haven't been there yet. You have an Indian restaurant right here. Haven't tried that yet. You have the Sugar Cane, which I've already reviewed. 5 out of 5, excellent choice for dinner. Have a sports bar here. Pretty much American food. Well, so right now, we're on the Ocean Springs side. You have Route 66 here. That's also American finger food. Trying to get in my camera. Don't mind her. She's photo bombing right now, or video bombing, I should say. You have Sakura, which is a hibachi restaurant. Haven't tried that yet, and I probably won't try it because I eat steak and rice all the time. I'm trying to switch it up a bit. You have another buffet here, Martha's Market. I'm here pretty much every day. It's one of my favorite buffets here.
Great food, 10 out of 10.
Great food, and on top of that, it has more of a variety. So, good varieties at Martha's versus...
Ice cream parlor here, rum ice cream.
Rum and raisin ice cream. That's one of my favorite type of ice cream. Rum and raisin is more commonly liked by Caribbean people. But they have a variety here. So come check out Ice Cream Parlor. Little gift shops here. Pretty much get everything you want, including if you want to propose on vacation, you go to the House of Diamonds. But
another showroom
here is called Showtime. I'm pretty much here between Showtime or the Census. They have great shows. I'm pretty much tuned in the entire show. All right, I look forward to those on a nightly basis. So now we are on the Ocean Springs side. And as I mentioned, if you stay at Ocean Eden, you also have access to this side. They're pretty much the same.
More restaurants, kid-friendly.
So Ocean Springs is kid-friendly. Ocean Eden is not kid-friendly. So you'll see more kids over here. Right, so if you're going on vacation and you wanna go on vacation with your family, your babies, your kids, then obviously you would go to Ocean Springs. But it's also beautiful over here. It's not much of a difference. You also have access to the beach. They have a ton of restaurants here as well. Also have a beautiful pool here. But now,
heading to the pool.
I am starving like Marvin, and I need something to eat. But just giving you a quick tour before I go and do that. But here's the other pool. They also have a lazy river here that I haven't tried yet that I'm looking forward to trying before I leave.
December's cool, so
yeah.
The water's cool too.
But this is Ocean Springs pool here. They also have a swim up bar. So again, it's not much difference. As a matter of fact, it looks a little more crowded over here than it is on that side. But that's mainly because of the kids, the families that are staying here. But yeah, so this is what Ocean Springs look like. And this also takes you straight to the beach. Okay, takes you straight to the beach. But again, nice property. My only complaint so far is that the pool is not heated. And around this time, the pools get a little cool. And if you know me from watching my other videos, you know that I do not do cold water, right? But here's the look. Hey, man. What's up, brother? Everything good? Yes, sir.
Is this your first time here?
Yeah.
Welcome, man.
Welcome to Jamaica. Welcome to the ocean. Well, I was born here.
Oh,
but I haven't been back in a while.
Oh, so you're in?
Yeah, I'm in Florida. States? Yeah, I'm in Florida.
Okay, so you're
a
Jamaican.
Yeah, I'm a Jamaican. If you want to call it that. Thank you, brother. I appreciate it, man. You have a good one. But one thing I'll say about Ocean Eden, Ocean Carroll Springs is that the hospitality is consistent. Right, when you go to other places, you might find one or two people who will greet you, talk to you. But here, everyone does. You know, everybody's greeting you, everybody's smiling. So hospitality in itself is definitely 4.5 out of 5, right? I won't grade it 5 because nothing is perfect, but for the most part, the hospitality here is great. But, you know, just giving y'all a tour. So if you decide to come visit, you'll know exactly what to look forward to. Hopefully I didn't spoil your fun too much, but this is it, y'all. So we decided tonight that we are going to try the steakhouse. Steakhouse on top. We're gonna try it, see what it's like, and review it. On the way to the jerk hut. I saw this place here on day one, but I was too busy eating everywhere else. Today's our last full day, so we decided that we're gonna try the jerk hut. As you can see, it's extremely packed, which is a good sign. That tells me the food is good. So it's tucked off all the way in the corner here on the Coral Springs side. And we actually didn't find it until later in our later in the day. So here we are, the jerk hut. We're gonna give it a try, see how this food is, see if it's authentic Jamaican food or not. Jamaican jerk hut. So this is what you get from the jerk hut. Looks good, looks like a traditional Jamaican plate. You also have some bami right here. But yes, real Jamaican traditional plate right here. So here I am. You know you have to go to KFC when you come to Jamaica. You gotta come to KFC, all right? So here we are in Jamaica right now. KFC Jamaica. It's a tradition. You gotta come to KFC when you come to Jamaica. YouTube, so I've came to the end of my stay here in the beautiful island of Jamaica. It was amazing to come back after 20 years of not being here, see my family, meet my brother, my dad for the first time in 20 years. We definitely rekindled, had some good conversations. We went and got some food together. It was a short visit, being that my dad had to go back to work, but it was definitely amazing seeing him after all those years. Overall, it was a beautiful time. The resort itself, if I had to review the resort, as you can see, is very beautiful. The hospitality is great in comparison to other places I've been. It's probably superior, to be honest with you. My only complaints with this place is that the water was very cold, the pool water. Now, I get it, you know, at this time of the year, I get it that majority of the year is warm because we're in a tropical island, but for this time of the year, with this month and the next couple of months, with it being a little cooler down here, it definitely makes it a little unbearable to get in the water with this colder weather down here that we're experiencing now. The hot tub itself was cool, but apart from that, the island itself is beautiful. We went to Bob Marley, did a few tours. Again, great experience overall. And listen, if you want to see more, please comment, subscribe, like, continue to tune in as I travel, as I explore every bit, and share every bit of my experience with you guys. All right, so comment, like, and subscribe, and let me know where you guys want to see me go next. Where do you want me to travel to next? Because the opportunities and the options are endless. I am going to do less islands, being that I've already been on a few of my last couple videos. I think my next trip is going to be in Europe. But please, again, share in the comments where you want to see me travel to next. Again, checking out Roger Roger, exploring every bit.